what? Optimum prefix code. Optimum means at its best of the cost, lowest cost. And prefix code, we need to understand that these are uniquely decodable codes. So these are the two priorities for coding. That is, we need to have the least cost and uniquely decodable codes. So that is why Hoffman code is called as optimum prefix code. Now, this particular code was developed by D. Hoffman in a class assignment. This is just a theory back for this history part. Construction of Hoffman codes is based on two ideas. Now, this is very important for us. In an optimum code, symbols with higher probability should have shorter code words. That means the symbols which are occurring frequently should have shorter code words, because they are occurring frequently, and they can, if we keep the length of the code word of those symbol as larger, then the complete code we will get will be quite large. So that is why the symbols which are occurring frequently should have shorter code words, and vice versa, right? That is why we are interested in keeping the variable length code versus fixed length code. These particular variable length codes are better as compared to fixed length, and this is the reason. In an optimum prefix code, the two symbols that occur least frequently will have the same length. Now, this is the point, that is, the two symbols that occur least frequently will have the same length. Now, let's see the algorithm for this particular Hoffman code, and we will relate it to a question, that is example, and we will solve it accordingly. Right. So now let's see what we have. We have in this, the algorithm says, that is, first of all, the first thing we need to do is we need to get the list of symbols in decreasing probability order. In question, we will be given the probability for each symbol. And what we need to do is we need to rank it in descending order, in decreasing order, according to the probability. So let's see the question. This is the question. In this, we have A is equal to A1 to A5, where the probability of A1 is 0.2, probability of A2 is 0.4, probability of A3 is 0.2, probability of A4 is 0.1, and probability of A5 is 0.1. Now let's see what we are going to do. The first thing is we are going to put it in decreasing order according to the probability. So 0.4 is the highest, then 0.2. Now, whenever we have two symbols with same frequency, we will follow the sequence order. So that means 0.2 and 0.2 are same, but in sequence, A1 is coming earlier. So we are going to keep A1 as but at first place only. Then we will keep A3, and same with A4 and A5. A4 and A5 are of same frequency, but still we are going to keep A4 at this sequence and then the A5. So this is the first step we are going to follow. That is, we have kept it in decreasing order. Now, second thing is combine pair of symbols with lowest probabilities. That is, those at the bottom of the list, as we have already sorted it in decreasing order. So we will have the symbols of lowest probabilities at the bottom itself, right? So what we are going to do is, next thing is, we are going to update probability of the new node, that is PS dash. We have taken sequence, so this is just a generalized form S. So when we are going to add the two probabilities SI and SJ, and we'll name it as S dash. Okay, so let's see it in the example how we are going to do it. Now see here, what we have in step two, we have taken step one was descending order. Okay, now see this particular part. The last two symbol probabilities will be added together, and then the new probability will be termed as S dash, and then it is sequenced in the same order, right? So let's say 0.1 and 0.1, we have added them together. So 0.1, 0.1 will be 0.2. And then we are going to place 0.2 according to the sequence, according to the descending order. This is 0.2, so coming in last only. If it would have been 0.5, let's say, so it would have come to the first point here. Okay, so according to the sequence, we are going to generate it. So what we have now, at the upper point, we are going to put 0 for this branch, and at the lower point, we are going to put 1 for this branch. Because what we are going to do, we are going to make a Hoffman tree as well, right? So this is going to be a Hoffman tree. So 0 for this node and 1 for lower node. Now we are going to repeat this particular process till we get onto one root node. Now next step is we have taken 0.2, again 0.2. These are two lowest probabilities. We are going to add these two, and the addition of these two will be 0.4, right? 0.2 plus 0.2 will be 0.4. So 0.4 will be placed where? Here. Now just remember, as I have told you earlier also, that if we are encountering the same probability like 0.4, already 0.4 is occurring, so I'm not going to put this 0.4 at the first point. No, it will be kept after, which is already placed. So after A2 only, I'm going to place 0.4. So this 0.4 comes here, not at the top. Again, upper branch 0, lower bound 1. Now again, we are going to follow same step, repeat these two lower frequencies to be added together, and it will give 0.6. Now this particular 0.6 is greater than the remaining one, that is 0.4. So it will come on the top here. So 0.6. Now upper point 0, lower one as 1. And here what we are going to define is, we are going to say 0.6 and 0.4 will come at the lower point. So 0 this one and 1 this one. And finally, we get 1. Okay. Addition of these two will be 0.6 plus 0.4 will be equal to 1. So now I have to find the code words for all these particular symbols. How to get the code words for these symbols? What we have to do is, first thing is, we need to find out, let's say for A5, this is A5, right? So for A5, how I'm going to get combine, this is the last procedure. Now we are going to see in the algorithm, what is the next point? The next point says, label the upper path of each branch node with a binary 0, we have already done, and the lower path with binary 1. We have already done this. Last step says scan tree from root to leaves to extract Hoffman code for each symbol. Now what we have to do, from root node to the leaves, I have to get the codes. So how will I get the codes? Just see here. This is the root node. So from root node, what I'll get, I'll get what? 0 point, this is 0 and this is 1. So for A2, what I'll get simply, this is A1. So for A1, what I'll get, this has 0 and 1, right? Then what I have next point, this is A3. For A3, what I'm going to get is, this is A3. So 0, 0 and 0. So that will be what? That will be 000. Just see here again, 0. Then I have to move here 0 and 0, right? So this is 000. Then I have 0, 1. One more thing, you can make this particular tree in vertical form also if you are getting little confused. right? So this is how I'll get all the code words for the Hoffman coding. Okay, so this is the way we are going to achieve the Hoffman code words. Now you can see all the codes are variable length. That means none of the code word is having fixed length. And you can see the least probability occurring symbols are having the maximum length code. And the one which has the higher probability is having the minimum length of code, right? This I was telling you earlier. So this has been proven from this particular code words. Now, next thing is what I have to do is now I have to find out the average length. How to find out the average length? So I have taken the picture of these particular code words. For A2, the code word is A1, A101, A3000, A40010, and A50011. So the formula for length, average length is capital L is for average length is equal to summation from K1 to N, P base K dot or multiplication L base K. Now K is going to change from here. I can say the n will be equal to 5. So k will be equal to 1 to 5 because we have 5 symbols. P, k will always go from 1 to 5. L, k will also go from 1 to 5. So now we have taken summation. So first thing L1, I'm going to say probability pk, that is P1 multiplied by L1. So P1 is 0.4 and L1, the length is 1 of this particular code word. So multiplied by 1 plus 0.2 is P2, probability of 2, that is 0.2 multiplied by 0.1. What is the length of code word? 2. So multiplied by 2. Then I have probability of A3 symbol. So P3 is 0.2 multiplied by the length of the code word. Length is 3. This is of 3 bits. So multiplied by 3. Then I have probability of A4 symbol, that is 0.1, and the length of the code word is 4 multiplied by 4. And same is with A5, 0.1 is the probability and multiplied by 4. So the average length I got is 2.2 bits per symbol. Okay. Now, after this, I'm going to calculate the entropy. Now for entropy, we have already seen in the earlier lectures also, what is the entropy, the formula for entropy? The formula for entropy is H is equal to summation K1 to N, we have already known this, PK log base 2, 1 divided by PK. So same thing we have to do here is K is equal to 1 to N is equal to 5. So 1 to 5, we are going to. So the calculation will give you what? 2.13 will be the entropy. Now comes the actual calculation. How do we calculate the efficiency of the code words? If I need to calculate the efficiency of the code word, Hoffman code, I need to calculate the redundancy, right? So to calculate the redundancy, what is the redundancy? Redundancy is the difference between the entropy and the average length of a code, right? Redundancy is the difference between the entropy and the average length of the code. So entropy is 2.13, we have already calculated. Average length is 2.2, already calculated. And then we'll give you the redundancy, that will be the difference of these two will be around 0.07 bits per symbol. So if a question comes in which you need to calculate the redundancy of or efficiency of a particular Hoffman code, what you are going to find out, you are first going to find out the code words for all the symbols through the algorithm, then calculate the average length, entropy, and then the redundancy. So I hope this is clear to you all. Thank you very much.